back out of it.
10-2. Way out, and they're still trying to drain us of our money. Mejor agarro my mom, and then she can record.
What?
That was a question.
Spoilers.
right behind it. Have the national anthem right behind it, ready to go.
Tis it is and tis it ever will be.
Be that time. Stay here. Stay mentally here.
Already gone.
Right on.
Thank you.
Good morning and welcome, family, friends, faculty, staff, and for sure candidates for degrees to Angelo State University's 2016 fall commencement. My name is Don Topliff, and as the Provost and Vice President of Affairs, it's my pleasure to serve as your host for this event. Please rise, and gentlemen, if you would remove hats for the presentation of colors by the Angelo State University ROTC Ram Guard. Immediately afterwards, Mr. will lead the singing. Thank you. Please be seated. Seated with me today are members of the official platform party whom I'd like to introduce and ask to stand at this time. If you would, please hold your applause until all of the introductions have been made. Deans of the colleges. Carolyn Gascoigne, Dean of the College of Arts and Humanities. Dr. Clifton T. Jones, Dean of the College of Business. Dr. P. Keith, Dean of the College of Graduate Studies, Dr. Leslie M. Mayran, Dean of the Archer College of Health and Human Services, Dr. Yasga Jr., Dean of the College of Education, Dr. Paul K. Sweats, Dean of the College of Science and Engineering, Dr. John M. Wagner Jr., Dean of the Freshman College. Also with us on the platform are Mr. Joe Munoz, the Senior Executive Assistant to the President and our General Counsel, Dr. Kimberly K. Livengood, President of the Faculty Senate, and Mr. Peyton LeBeau, President of Student Government Association. Please join me in welcoming these individuals to our event. At the heart of every great university is its faculty, who guide and mentor. I'd like to ask the members present today to please rise and be recognized. It's now my distinct pleasure to introduce the President of Angelo State University, Dr. Brian.
It is both an honor and a pleasure today to introduce to you Dr. Hector Gonzalez, President of Southwest Texas Junior College in Uvalde, and your fall commencement speaker. By the end of this ceremony, you will have something in common with Dr. Gonzalez. You will graduates as well. As the president of Southwest Texas Junior College, Dr. Gonzalez oversees operations of 7 campuses with a total of more than 5,600 students, about 200 faculty, and technical programs, and with an annual operating budget of over $43.5 million. The academic programs include the cooperative STEP West Texas program between Southwest Texas Junior College and Angelo State University that is designed to enable students to complete their associate's degree in engineering science in Southwest Texas and transfer to Angelo State to complete their bachelor's degree in civil engineering. Dr. Gonzalez has actually been at Southwest Texas since 1999. He first joined the staff as Director of Accounting and was then promoted to Chief Academic Officer and Chief Financial Officer in 2003. He served in that capacity until being named President in 2012. Along the way, he was recognized by U.S. President Barack Obama as a champion for change in community colleges in 2011. And he helped lead Southwest recognition as a top 10 community college Aspen Institute in 2012. Prior to joining the college ranks, Dr. Gonzalez had significant experience in accounting and business. He spent 7 years as the chief financial officer for Tandem Petroleum Marketing in Uvalde, and then his 5 years as staff accountant and auditor for the Coleman Horton and Company Accounting and Business. It was while working for Coleman Horton and Company that he got his first taste of academia as an member at Sol-Ross State University in Alpine. In addition to leading Southwest Texas Junior College, Dr. Gonzalez is also a leader in the Uvalde community. He served on the board of directors for the Uvalde Memorial Hospital since 2001, including a stint as president from 2010 to 2013. During that time, he led the hospital's strategic planning process that included development of the Kate Merriam Regional Cancer Center. He also served in leadership positions at the Development Foundation and Uvalde Area Chamber of Commerce. He is also active in Uvalde Sacred Heart Catholic Church and School. Dr. Gonzalez earned his Bachelor's of Business Administration in Accounting at Angelo State University in 1992. After transferring here from Southwest Junior College, he earned his Master's degree in Business Administration from Sol-Ross State University, and he earned his Doctorate in Organizational Leadership from the University of Incarnate Word in San Antonio. He is also a certified public accountant and a private pilot. He lives in Jacqueline and their daughter, Mia. Please join me in the state's very own, Dr. Hector Gonzalez.
Good morning. Sure feels good to be back at home. It is such a great honor to be here with you today, and God bless America and all of its opportunities for allowing such an opportunity to me. This has to be one of the highest forms of recognition I have to be asked to give the commencement address at my own alma mater. Wow, it's amazing. When I sat there about 24 years ago, I never thought or dreamt that I'd be up here giving an address for this same university. ASU has a very special place in my heart. It provided the educational foundation for all the success in my career. And now I've been entrusted to share with you about about 10 minutes. But this advice is the last that will help you as you turn the next. Dr. May, the faculty, administration, and you, the graduates, for affording me this opportunity this morning. First of all, congratulations. This is an amazing accomplishment. Your college education provides you a solid foundation for success. But unlike past generations, it has been transformed from a manufacturing-based economy economy, and the importance of a college can be compared to that of a high school education 40 years ago. It serves as a gateway to better options and more opportunities. However, education is but the first step. Your next step is to build and to define who you are. You are about to enter a challenging world. It's extremely competitive out there. Many of you are in search of that first job. That in itself is a daunting task. There are many not so perfect jobs out there that can provide you the building blocks and the opportunity to find that ideal job. So I want to share my story, the story of how perfect jobs led to rewarding opportunities, which eventually led me to the perfect job. This story begins with an 18-year-old that began working with Frito, and it worked his way up to be a college president. Unconventional path, to say the least. Historian, and probably from the bio, there's a lot of unconventional transitions that have occurred in my careers. I never dreamt of being a college president. I mapped out my previous job experiences. I found that every single position that I held helped me prepare me for this current position. The first summer after graduating, landed the job with Frito-Lay. It was a small position, part of the training was a week-long intensive training in Plano. But I quickly realized that as an 18-year-old, I was holding a great deal of responsibility. I was entrusted with $50,000 worth of inventory. Doing the math, it would have taken me years at the current salary to pay back any kind of mistake. This responsibility with grave concern, and I knew a mistake. One might say, how lay chips to opportunities leading to a college president. Looking back, I can see that learning and taking for knowing that my work ethic would determine keep me on as an employee. This is very similar to the responsibility for the day-to-day planning involved in running a successful college. Recognizing that I am responsible for my job has served me well throughout all my jobs. Frito-Lay was not the perfect job, but it did provide me with a great opportunity to learn firsthand responsibility for myself. I knew that a single mistake would impact other people. I also knew that I could be turned. At the time, this job served its purpose. It provided good money for college and taught about people. I know many of you have already experienced these type of jobs, the not so perfect jobs. Thinking back over the years in college, I'm sure you probably held all these positions. And I'm willing to positions you have learned and taken. I work for Frito-Lay every single day from ASU. I had a degree and I graduated with my accounting and dreams to being a CPA. So I studied and took the CPA exam. However, I discovered that I still needed 2 work experience after passing the exam. And I had no avenue to gain the work experience that I needed. But I learned that if I had a master's degree, I decided on my MBA. I took 9 classes, and 2.5 years later, I was sitting before professors during the oral exam that I was reading. At the end of the exam, the department chair asked if I'd be interested in teaching adjunct, though I did not feel that was a perfect job either. It proved to be one of the best choices that I've ever made. As an adjunct professor, I learned many skills that would later help me in facilitating the college learning experience. I learned how to engage my students, to just get them to make it to class. As a student transitioning into the instructor role, I'll be the first to tell you that the view from the opposite side is different. It's different engaged. And you also practice and practice in order to get that message across. I learned that even though I initially thought of this position as not, I can now see how the experience has also helped me in developing the strategic college I lead. My experience as a faculty helped me. My job provided me with just enough experience in the classroom that would later open up a huge opportunity for me. So there I was with a few not so perfect jobs on my resume, and I still wasn't sure how I was going to complete the hours required for my class. That is until I finally found a break with one of my tax clients. He had recommended me for another position at a local accounting firm. Opportunity to finally get into that perfect job and also get the work experience and get my CPA license. Looking back, I thought, wow, this is wonderful. This is whom I wanted to be when I grew up. This is my career. I was gaining valuable experience auditing banks, school districts, and I learned to dreaded auditing standards, risk assessments that I had learned in college, and more importantly, got the work experience license. It was a wonderful time in my life. I was learning and gaining value, but as you know, it didn't end there. Several years later, a friend of mine informed me of a vacancy at the local college for a controller. I wasn't too sure about this position, and I discovered it would be a cut in my pay. But it did have a bit of an incentive. Benefits, retirement, and additional opportunities for promotion. I recalled a partners, and he would reminisce about a time that he should have taken advantage of the same opportunity, but he let it go by because it was a cut in pay. He would have been the chief financial officer by now, but he let that opportunity pass. I never forgot his story. So I decided to apply and was hired. I finally had a good job, almost perfect. My boss at the time later shared with me what set me apart from the other candidates. First, my CPA license. Second, my school districts. And third, my experience as an adjunct professor. The skills gained during my early careers, even though it was just a snapshot, it helped me get a leg up on the competition. I quickly put my skills to work. I was in charge of investing in financial reporting. And thanks to being around my dad's business as a child, I had a knack for business. I had the ability to visualize future expected outcomes and form necessary steps to get us there. This proved to be very helpful in managing our college planning for the future. 5 years later, I became the academic dean. It was a bit unorthodox for the controller to advance academics at the college. In the back of the room are probably saying, yep, 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 right? The president was confident in my appointment to this position. In conversations with him, he shared with me that he had promoted me to that position because I had experience in the classroom, had command for the budget, but more importantly, I was a good leader. A short time after that, my appointment to the academic dean position, I was presented with yet another opportunity. The role of chief financial officer and chief academic officer. I took the opportunity back. Even though I would never recommend it to anyone, this was finally the perfect job. At times, I had schizophrenic moments. Half of me wanted to spend money, half would say, no, you can't. But it provided me the perfect platform to really get some things done for the college. This perfect job was preparing me to be the college president. 3 years ago, the board appointed me to be the 10th West Texas Junior College. Amazing. Looking back over the years and all my career opportunities and job choices that I made, I would have never as being a president at our local college. Each career taught me something valuable, developed today. This journey began the summer of 1988 when I was that Frito-Lay truck. As I transitioned from each job, I realized that I learned many things. Things that unfortunately would not be taught in a college or university classroom. On the job experiences, real life stress to truly know how to decipher through and solve real life problems. These type of careers and experiences is what you want to say yes to. It means sometimes take a risk on a new job, a job that might not seem so perfect. I want to share a quote from one of my favorite movies, one that I happened to be on last night and watched it in the hotel room, Apollo 13. You never know what events will transpire to get you home. Well, the same thing happens with your career. You never know what job will lead you to your career. I cannot emphasize enough how preparation and a little can have such a profound impact on your future. Take the risk, find these, and know that in every job is a learning that will affect your future. Student and graduate of Angelo State University, I want to end by saying, honor to be here with you today. Remember, don't get hung up on looking for that perfect job. Focus on continued growth and don't stress about what you do. Focus about who you are becoming, and what you're meant to do will become clear over time. Today we live in challenging times. Different. It changes so rapidly, but I know you've been prepared well. I was prepared by this. Now it's your accomplishments. And let tomorrow's chapter. I have faith in you. May God bless you and your family. Now go out and make us all proud. Congratulations, class of 2016.
Thank you, Dr. Gonzalez. I know that many of us in this audience can identify with what the message that was just brought to us. So again, thank you. Before awarding degrees, I'd like to recognize a group of undergraduates whose outstanding academic performance has special distinction. So as I call your particular category, I'd ask you to stand. The following academic honors: summa cum laude from with a grade point average of 3.9 to 4.0. Stand. You may be seated. Magna cum laude, average of 3.7 to 3.0. Would that group of students please stand? You may be seated. With a grade point average of 3.5 to 3.69. Would those students please stand? Congratulations, students, on those outstanding. We'd also like to recognize students who the graduation requirements for the Angelo State University. Will those students graduating with high university honors please give them a round of applause for their exceptional academic achievements? Those graduating with high university honors. You may be seated. And now it's time to award degrees. First, would the candidates for the master's degree please stand and remain standing? President May, on behalf of the faculty, present the candidates for the master's degree. These candidates have fulfilled all requirements set forth by the university, and that each be awarded and earned.
By the authority vested in me by the Texas Tech University system, I hereby confer upon each of you and upon those graduating the appropriate degree.
You may be seated. Would the candidates for the bachelor's degree in each of the colleges please stand as your designated college is called and remain standing. First, the Archer College of Health and Human Services. Candidates, please stand. Please remain standing. Would those from the College of Education please stand? President May, on behalf of the faculty, the deans and I present the candidates for the bachelor's degrees. These candidates have fulfilled all the requirements as set forth, and we recommend be awarded the degree earned.
By the authority vested in me by the Board of Regents of the Texas Tech University System, I confer upon each of you and upon those in absentia the appropriate.
Thank you. You may be seated. Proceed with the individual awarding of diplomas. Commencement ceremony progressing smoothly. We'd ask that you until the last student from each department has been recognized. I'd like to call your attention to the fact that we have a professional photographer who will take photographs as they cross the stage, where they will pause for a picture with President May. Dr. Mark Hammond, Professor of English, will announce the graduates' names. Faculty marshals, would you please prepare the graduates to be recognized?
Graduate Studies. Leading the master's candidate, Health and Human Services, is Dr. Leslie Mayrand, to my left. Dean of the Archer College of Health and Human Services, Dr. Susan Keith. Veronica. Kit Chambers. Suzanne Teresa Cockrell. Cody. Derek Stanley Durst. Joshua Logan Ellis. Symphony Lee Danielle Fisher. Ellen Ray Gift. Jessica Joanna Serrat Gonzalez. Teresa Lee Phi Kappa Phi. Belinda Renee Hefner. Herrera. Carlos E. Mack. Krista Molina Magallanes. Marie Antonia Martinez. Alyssa Miller. Ramiro Moreno, Phi Kappa Phi. Lisa A. Payne. Glenn Michael Revell. Talon Smith. Nikki Springer. Kyle Washington. Icy Nicole Wilborn. And please honor these graduates with a round of applause. In the College of Education is Dr. John J. Miazga, Dean of the College of Education, and Dr. Susan E. Keith, Graduate Studies. Aaron Marie Acker, Phi Kappa Phi. Lauren Ashley Barber. Vanessa Batts. Amy Lynn Bohensky. Lacey Myers Bowman. Camille Marie Brenning. Ryan Carboni. Alejandro Castro. Jana Reasonover Castro. Veronica. Fred Cervantes Jr. E. Koger, Phi Kappa. Dora Verania Colvin, Phi Kappa Phi. Nancy Antonia Connolly. Angela Dean. Paula Jo Easley. Warnini Bartolad Figueiredo. Ford Phi Kappa Phi. Kathleen S. Fulton Phi Kappa Phi. Angelica Maria Garner Phi Kappa Phi. Tiffany Nicole Glosson. Gracie Ann Gonzalez, Phi Kappa Phi. Sue Hall, Phi Kappa Phi. David Lance Heath. Lindsay D. Hood Arenales. Cheyenne Jackson, Phi. Nadia Kadari, Phi Kappa Phi. Jana Lauren Lee. Candace Jolynn Massar. Brittany Colleen McKinney. Farron Jade Tanik Miller. Maria Juana Moncada. Lori. Lindsay Elise Kappa Phi. Sally Morell, Phi Kappa Phi. Sylvia Renee Naranko Blaschke. Kristen Ray Oney. Julia Ann Kappa Phi. Rosemary. Carrie Peacock, Phi Kappa Phi. Ricky Devon Pelzer. Amy Torres Perez, Phi Kappa Phi. Evangelina Nicole Perez. Alexandria Lisette Ramirez, Phi Kappa Phi. Whitney Neumeyer Rose. Gloria Alicia Rubalcaba. Erin Ashley Ruiz. JC Sailor Carroll. Kendra Joyce Phi Kappa Phi. Melissa Weeks Subject. Kimberly Dawn Sullivan. Ashley Brianna Tim. Chelsea Annette Towler, Phi Kappa Phi. Rachel Alicia Villanueva. Melinda J. Wandley. Please honor these graduates with a round of applause. The Arthur College of Health and Human Services, leading the is Dr. Kathleen Price, representative. Dylan Anthony Adai. Cynthia Brooke Andrews. Natanya Lean Bowsley. Brady, magna cum laude. Rebecca Jean Kane. Joshua Paul Crumley, summa cum laude. Adrian Nathaniel Dilworth. Sterling Daniel Eckert, Alpha Chi, Phi Kappa Phi. Madison Brooke Ellis, cum laude. Henry. Sheldon Howard Gatewood. Jane Gibbs. Jontry Devon Goff. Jorge Gonzalez. Lauren Nicole Gordon. Samuel Luke Guevara. Tyler Reese Hamilton. Melissa Ray Hawkins, cum laude. Chelsea Devon Henderson. Nicole, summa cum laude, Alpha Chi. Matthew Christopher Hummingbird. Deshaun Johnson. Kathleen Ann, cum laude, Alpha Chi, high honors. Clinton, magna cum laude. Montejano. Gustavo Arrián Padilla. Ashley Paige Phillips. Ryan Daniel Reed, summa cum laude, Alpha Phi Kappa Phi, High University Honors. Taylor Lane Robinson. Alexis Nicole Segura Sanders. Jill Scott. Joshua Lee Sparkman, cum laude. Hayden Story. Noel Trevino, magna cum laude, Alpha Chi, Phi Kappa Phi. Jonathan Vasquez. Shelby Lynn Waller. Jacqueline Shea Yandell. Please honor these graduates with a round of applause. Leading Dr. Rena Gabbert, Department. Elizabeth Adams, cum laude. Maria Luz Arrocha. Krista Barnes. Megan Jo Bowers. Caitlin. Courtney Jordana Brown. Castro, cum laude. Mariah Nicole Chambers, cum laude. Paul Adam Klein, magna cum laude. Jenna Condren. Juan Manuel Corona. Kimberly Ebeling. Hannah Joy Eberhart. Aaron Renee Ferrara. Foster, cum laude. Emily Frerich. Kahila Carolina Gomez. Jasmine Gonzalez. Cody. Joseph Roy Huro. Danielle Jones. Madison Martin. Kirsten Rayanne McCoy, cum laude, Alpha Chi. Christine Morris. Meredith Rose Preston. Tanoa Joyce Richardson. Allison Diane Salcido. Rebecca Emily Vela, cum laude. Christian Ernesto Villatorro, cum laude, Alpha Chi. Emily Morgan. Alex Papa John Woodward. Please honor these graduates with a round of applause. Leading the Department of Psychology, Sociology, and Social Work is Dr. James N. Department Chair. Stefan Nestor Alba. Margaret Arroyo. Jessica Barker, summa cum laude, Alpha Phi Kappa Phi. Allison Nicole Claxton, cum laude. Brett Clayton Edwards. Teresa Esquivel. Lee. Anthony Garza Jr. Ben Gray. Bell Humphrey. Kathleen Ann Kotz. Deidre D. Knox, cum laude. Morgan Lee. Anthony Ray Lopez. Judith Lopez. Stephanie Blair Madigan. Stacy Nicole Olinger. Toshido Paz. Angela de la Peña Ramirez. Jennifer L. Ramirez. Reyes. Keith Jeffrey Lloyd. Cum laude. Liliana Ruiz. Swanson. Courtney Ariel Tamplin. Samantha Nicole Tobias. Devin Van. Richard Dylan Whitley. Please honor these graduates with a round of applause.
Thank you.
Congratulations, Angelo State University, class of 2016. Let's give them a round of applause. Better now. That's more like it. I'd like to now introduce Adams, the director of the ASU Alumni Association, to bring a message to our new graduates.
Graduates, would you please stand? On behalf of the ASU Alumni Association, it is with great honor to ask the graduates of the class of 2016 to please move the tassel on right to the left as a symbol of commencement at Angelo State University. If you have a now turn your ring to signify your status as alumni of Angelo State University. If you would please continue to stand for me, graduates, I would like to ask all ASU alumni who are in the audience or on the platform, please stand and join our graduates. Today, you begin a new role as a graduate and join over 43,000 ASU alumni. Ambassador for this university. Please join me in a round of applause for our new ASU alumni. You may be seated. Members of the University Alumni Association. Membership in the Alumni Association honors, privilege, and responsibilities. As an alumni, you have a great responsibility. ASU continues its upward growth and getting involved. It was the enthusiasm of our alumni and the support of Bob and Jean Ann LeGrand that built the LeGrand Alumni and Visitor Center so that you have a home when you come back to campus. On behalf of the ASU Alumni Association, I congratulate you on your individual accomplishments, and I challenge each of you and involved with the Ram family as you continue your quest. Thank you, and go Rams.
Thank you, Kim. I now invite the class of 2016, the platform faculty, and all members of the audience to please stand and join in the singing of the alma mater led by Ms. available on the back page of
to come. He shall speak of Angelostate University. Then let us raise our voices in praise. Truth we seek to set us free. In time to come, when our ideals shall come reality, and let us praise thee, our Mater, at State University.
Thank you, Kim. I'd now ask that members of the audience and remain seated for the recessional of the platform party, the faculty. The fall 2016 commencement of Angelo State University is hereby. Thank you.